This was the scene at the Portland airport today, but the conditions are only part of the travel nightmare across the Northwest. Plus, holiday travelers are dealing with the frustration of hundreds of canceled flights during the past few days. We'll have the latest from the Eugene airport. And a heavenly image is captured on camera outside a sick teen's hospital room. We'll have all the details. Fox News at 10 starts right now.
You're watching Fox News at 10, Western Oregon's only 10 o'clock news.
Good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us for Fox News at 10. I'm Natasha Chughtai. We'll get to the flight delays in just a moment, but first, Tim's here to explain why the Southern Willamette Valley seems to be the only place that's not getting hit with a blizzard. Tim?
Well, Natasha, the explanation to this is really quite simple. It's an old saying in sales. What are the three most important rules? Location, location, location. It's where we are in relation to where the cold air has been. You can see this little stationary front kind of stuck. Well, that means all the cold air has been just coming down, and that's it, stuck here. We've been coming with the circulation of getting a little bit warmer air from the south. Add that together, and boy, that's the difference between having dry pavement, pretty much, maybe a few icy spots, and inches upon inches of snow up north in Portland. All right, here's where the precip was during the day today. You can see it. It all changed to rain and then changed to snow, and you'll notice most of it's pretty much passed at this point. We will see a little bit more, and we do have some advisors in effect. These are winter storm watches in that color. In this color, it's a winter storm warning for tomorrow. We'll talk more about that in just a few minutes. Back to you, Natasha.
All right, thanks, Tim. Well, here's a picture of the Portland airport earlier today where there's still snow on the ground. More snow and icy rain fell last night, adding to the fender benders, power outages, and downed tree limbs that have been accumulating all weekend. Chains are required in the city, but officials say if you don't have to go out, try not to. The snow up north is causing major headaches for travelers. Flights in and out of Seattle and Portland have been canceled throughout the day. Molly Blancett reports.
We just arrived from New York City.
How long did it take you to get here?
Since yesterday morning.
The friendly skies haven't been so friendly the last few days.
This has been very frustrating.
We came from Hawaii to Seattle, and then we were stuck. And they just told us, well, figure out your own way. Everything's canceled. Go home.
Pete Jorgensen got stuck in Seattle on Sunday. Instead of waiting out the storm, he and his family rented a car and drove back to Eugene. It's a trip that usually takes about 5 hours.
How long did it take you to drive down here?
John, 9 hours or something? 9 hours.
And in Portland, the airport looks more like a motel, packed with stranded travelers after more than 100 flights were canceled. At the Eugene Airport, I'm Molly Blancett reporting.
Meantime, the snow is causing all sorts of transportation troubles, even for the railways. Amtrak service from Eugene to British Columbia came to a halt earlier today after three cars derailed in Portland. In Eugene, the Amtrak station was packed with stranded travelers.
Well, we're pretty much trapped now, but we're staying anyway because we got the ticket and we're heading north anyway.
The arrival and departure screens didn't give travelers much hope, nearly every trip canceled or delayed. Telephone outages in Western Lane County have volunteer firefighters on standby tonight in case someone can't call 911 in an emergency. Volunteers are manning the Lane Rural Fire and Rescue's Franklin Station and the fire station in Junction City. The phone company believes the outage started this afternoon when someone stole a section of cable.
There's not good cell service in this area, so we're down here staffing the station in case people need to. If they have an emergency, they can come down the station, bang on the doors, and there'll be somebody here. Unfortunately, we have, the doors are secure, so they have to actually bang on the doors.
The volunteers will be there 24/7 until phone service is restored. The deals are there, so are the workers, but the shoppers are not. Shibani Joshi of Fox Business Network reports.
You could call it the Grinch that stole Christmas. For retailers, at least, an economy on edge and a blast of winter weather are keeping many would-be shoppers at home. Worried retailers are pulling out all the stops. More than a dozen Macy's stores are welcoming shoppers 24/7.
People who work in the medical industry, firemen, policemen who can't shop because our hours don't work for their schedule. So it gives us a whole market of people that we normally can't tap into.
In Times Square, the sprawling Toys R Us store is betting on night owls to help beef up its sales by keeping its doors open around the clock. Shoppers in Chicago, hungry for bargains, are finding marvelous deals on the Magnificent Mile.
We've seen really good bargains, things that you don't normally see before the holiday season, or things can seem to be on sale, so we've got some really good deals.
So there are deals to be had, but not necessarily the shoppers to snap them up. In parts of the Midwest and the Northeast, a powerful winter storm could spoil this typically lucrative season for the stores. People are more concerned with digging out and keeping warm than splurging at the mall.
It could be a very dark Christmas for a lot of retailers and a lot of companies, because there's going to be nothing to pick this consumption up, certainly in the first quarter of next year.
One trade organization says this could be the worst holiday shopping season since it started tracking the numbers back in 1969. In New York, Shabani Joshi, the Fox Business Network.
Local retailers are also feeling the pinch and reeling from the 1-2 punch of the bad economy and the bad weather. At Eugene Toy and Hobby, the holiday rush is finally in full swing. The week of snow and ice kept shoppers from showing up in full force. After a very slow start, the store is finally busy.
The holiday season is always important for every retailer. My heart goes out to some of these people that are just really, really hurting. I mean, it's sad to see some of these places closing. We are just so thankful that we have so many loyal, long-term customers.
Eugene Toy and Hobby has weathered other economic storms. They're tightening their belts and hoping the recession doesn't last long. Starting and owning your own business can be a rewarding experience, but it's often hard to do in tough times like these. Lane Microbusiness Program advisors say more people may be interested in taking that step now, but they need to be smart. They say lower capital costs right now could provide the open door for opportunities.
We really try to encourage folks to think about, you know, what are those everyday things that people really need to have, you know, get done? You know, can you provide it in a cost-effective manner?
You have to have an idea of what you want to do, but then you have to also just be really flexible and listening to what the people are wanting.
Fannin got a loan from Lane Microbusiness to make improvements to her business website. Times are tough and many people are being laid off, left to look for work in a slumping economy. And it's difficult to deal with the blow when an employee hears the bad news. Sandra Endo has more.
Two words you don't want to hear at work.
You're fired.
The phrase made famous by Donald Trump in The Apprentice is now ringing in the ears of hundreds of thousands of Americans being laid off in recent months. Patricia McKinney is one of them.
To be laid off, it was not a good feeling because it was unexpected. And when it did happen, you know, you think, well, I'll find something. And it's just been all downhill everywhere you go.
But there are ways to make a graceful exit when you get let go. Career advisors say keep your anger and disappointment in check and instead position yourself for the future.
The worst thing an individual can do is to get stuck in that emotional zone and not to move on. If you're looking ahead, if you're being practical, that gives you control back to your situation.
Leaving on the best terms possible could also get you a letter of recommendation to use for your job hunt. And career advisors say now is the time to bone up on new skills.
A lot of folks realize they have to change their industry, that they have to look for something different, and they have to get more education or get more training to find a new job.
It's also helpful to seek out career centers in your neighborhood and go online to expand your search. Career advisors say the stigma that was once attached to being fired is now pretty much non-existent. In Washington, I'm Sandra Endo.
The Lane Memorial Blood Bank needs your help this holiday season. They're looking for the following blood types listed on your screen. Donating is easy and only takes about 45 minutes. For more information about donating, you can visit the Blood Bank's website at lmbb.org. Still ahead on Fox News at 10, Democrats are under pressure to pull off what could be the biggest bash Washington has ever seen. See how they're preparing when we return.
Cover covering Eugene, Springfield, and all of Western Oregon. This is Fox News at 10 with Natasha Chughtai, Tim Chewy Weather.